Nick, I mean, 30 years on since the fall of the Berlin Wall, what does all of this mean to the average German person?
I think a lot of questions are being asked at this particular commemoration. You know, I was here 5 years ago, and people were pretty jubilant. There's a widespread recognition this time, as there was last, that the fall of the wall was an amazing historical event, a bloodless revolution. Let's remember, in 1989, there was also the Tiananmen Square massacre when Chinese people were trying to reach for democracy, and it didn't end well. However, this time around, there's a recognition that the ideas of populism and authoritarianism are spreading in the West. To use the words of the American Secretary of State, Mike Pompeo, who was here yesterday, he said, in the afterglow of that proud moment, the West and all of us, he said, lost our way. And I think we're seeing that in some of the Central European countries that are represented here today, Czech Republic, Slovakia, Poland and Hungary. Hungary's Prime Minister Viktor Orban talking of a new illiberal democracy in his country. And also concern about the transatlantic alliance, Donald Trump questioning the utility of NATO and the European Union. And then just the domestic problems in Germany are causing Germans to ask themselves questions about what it all means. The rise of the far-right Alternative for Germany party, which is the number two political force in this country, scored well in the most recent regional elections in eastern Germany, really has people wondering if those hopes that were born 30 years ago are still, you know, coming to reality in terms of a stable, healthy, functioning democracy where human rights are respected.